All right. So this is where we were. This is exercise 1.3 from your textbook. We have discussed question number 1, 2, 9th and 7th. So question number 1 has been discussed. If anyone wants to ask anything, please let me know. You have to convert these into decimal numbers and then write down what type of expansion each of these have. We have done question number 2 where the expansion for 1 by 7 was given, and using this, you had to predict the expansions for these rational numbers without actually doing the long division. So what we do is we express all of these fractions, 2 by 7, 3 by 7, etc., as multiples of 1 by 7, and then we can use the value, the decimal value for 1 by 7 in those multiples to find out their respective values. And they are saying study the remainders while finding the value 1 by 7 carefully. You see there is a pattern there. Then after this, I told you that questions have been deleted from your exercise. These are question number 5th and 6th. Question number 5th and 6th have been deleted. So you can just mark that down for yourself. And apart from this, I discussed question number 9th and 8th with you. So question number 9th here was about classifying the numbers as rational or irrational. Looking at the numbers, you cannot just say that those are rational or irrational. You can tell whether a number is rational or irrational based on their decimal expansion. So for each of these numbers, look at the decimal expansion. For rational, the decimal expansion should be either terminating, it should come to an end, like in this one, after 4 decimal places, it comes to an end, or it should be non-terminating and repeating. So non-terminating is the one shown with points at the end, dashes at the end, and repeating means there is a group of digits. It could be just one digit or more digits which are repeating themselves, and that's shown by putting a bar on top. So this could be written as 7.478 and a bar on top. So that means 478 keeps on repeating. Then for second part, the answer is 15, and it is not a decimal number as such. It's a whole number, and all whole numbers are rational numbers. One way. The other is you could write this as a decimal number. That will be 15.0. In that case also, it's non-terminating. It's terminating. And if you want to write it as non-terminating, you will have 15.0 bar. So non-terminating but repeating. Then for root 23, I told you to find out the square root up to 2 or 3 decimal places, and then write down that since the value is a non-terminating, non-repeating decimal number, 223 is irrational. Other than that, there is a fact that if you have under root, a prime number under the root, the answer is always irrational. Then we discussed question number 7th. Write 3 numbers whose decimal expansions are non-terminating, non-recurring. So, apni taraf se aapko numbers likhne hain. Decimal form mein numbers likhne hain. Aur aapko do baaton ka dhyan rakhna hai. Last mein uske dashes hone chahiye. The number should not come to an end. And it should be non-recurring. So, for this particular part, I told you to use this sort of number. Question 9th ka jo last part hai, aap is tarah ke numbers bana sakte ho. Jahan pe aap point se pehle kuch bhi likh sakte ho. पॉइंट के बाद आपने जो डिजिट्स लिखने हैं उनमें कोई पैटर्न नहीं बनना चाहिए. एंड सेकंड थिंग, यू नीड टू यूज डैशेस एट द एंड. दीज टू थिंग्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन यू वांट टू राइट डाउन दीज टाइप ऑफ नंबर्स, इरेशनल नंबर्स. एंड व्हाई आई डिस्कस्ड दिस फर्स्ट, बिकॉज दिस इज रिक्वायर्ड इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, एंड दिस इज द वन व्हिच वी वर डिस्कसिंग यस्टरडे. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, 3 डिफरेंट इरेशनल नंबर्स between these two. अब अगर ये question होता from exercise 1.1, जहाँ पे आपको rational numbers find करने थे, you would have proceeded very simply. These are two different types of questions. बेटा बहुत ध्यान से करना exam में. कई बार दोनों पूछ लेते हैं. Sometimes they say write down 3 rational and 3 irrational numbers between the given rational numbers. So there are 3 types of question: rational numbers between given 2 rational numbers, find irrational numbers between 2 given rational numbers, and then find both. Find rational as well as irrational numbers between any 2 given rational numbers. So to proceed for this particular question, where you have to find out irrational numbers, the first step is to convert these into
decimals.
रैशनल नंबर, एलसीएम वाला पार्ट आप रैशनल में यूज करते हो. जब आपको रैशनल नंबर्स ढूंढने हैं, लाइक इन एक्सरसाइज 1.1, द वंस व्हिच यू हैव डन इन 7th स्टैंडर्ड 8th स्टैंडर्ड, वो वाले जो क्वेश्चंस थे जहां पे आपको रैशनल नंबर्स फाइंड करने हैं बिटवीन दीज टू, वहां पे हम एलसीएम लेते हैं. अगर आपको इन दोनों के बीच में इरेशनल नंबर्स ढूंढने हैं तो पहला स्टेप होगा टू कन्वर्ट देम इनटू डेसिमल नंबर्स. दैट्स व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू यस्टरडे, टू कन्वर्ट दीज इनटू डेसिमल फॉर्म. दैट विल बी योर फर्स्ट स्टेप. सो इफ यू वांट, लेट्स जस्ट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग एंड देन जस्ट टू हैव एन आइडिया. This is exercise 1.3. It's on page number 14 in your textbooks, and we are doing question number 8 now. We have to find three irrational numbers. Between 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. Remember, this is type 2. टाइप वन आपने जो की थी वो थी फाइंड रैशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन 5 by 7 एंड 9 by 11. दिस इज द टाइप विच यू हैव स्टडीड इन 7th स्टैंडर्ड 8th स्टैंडर्ड एंड द फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर राइट नाउ इन 9th स्टैंडर्ड. इसमें हम एलसीएम लेके करते हैं. हम सबसे पहले इनको लाइक रैशनल नंबर्स बनाते हैं, उसके बाद अगर आपको बीच में नंबर्स मिल रहे हैं जितने आपको चाहिए, वेल एंड गुड. अदरवाइज हम फिर किसी और नंबर से मल्टीप्लाई करते हैं. यू कैन मल्टीप्लाई विद 10, 5 और 100 और व्हाटएवर, डिपेंडिंग कि आपको कितने नंबर्स चाहिए और आपको वो मिल जाएंगे या नहीं आफ्टर द मल्टीप्लिकेशन. द मल्टीप्लिकेशन मींस कन्वर्टिंग योर लाइक रैशनल नंबर्स इनटू इक्विवेलेंट रैशनल नंबर्स फर्दर. नाउ दिस इज द क्वेश्चन व्हिच यू हैव नॉट डन अर्लियर. सो दिस रिक्वायर्स यू टू कन्वर्ट द गिवन रैशनल नंबर्स इनटू decimal numbers. So that will be your first step. Convert given rational numbers into decimal form. And this may or may not be terminating decimal form. So jab aap dono ko convert karoge, 5 by 7, so carry out the division of 5 by 7 and then carry out the division of 9 by 11. So let's just quickly do this if you had to. So you will use a point and then can use a zero and just do a few steps until you see a pattern or your division terminates. Ya to aapki division terminate ho jani chahiye ya fir it should show you a repeating pattern. So in this case what you will realize is that it does not terminate, it instead shows a repeating pattern. So over here, if you have not done it already, I would like you to do it with me. So at this step, we have reached the number from where we started. जहां से हमने begin किया था वहीं पे पहुंच गए हम. So once you realize you're back to the beginning, that would mean यहां पे आपकी जो expansion है it would start to follow a pattern. तो आपके पास ये sequence 7, 1, 4, 2, 8, 5 repeat होगा.
Then we have to divide it till we get the number that is starting.
You will be able to see the sequence because 5 aaya, aap iske saath 0 lagaoge, right? Fir aap yahan pe 7 likhoge, niche 49 aa jayega. I'll just show you. Yahan pe 49 aa jayega. Fir remainder 1 bacha, aap ek aur 0 lagaoge. You will use 1 and then it will be 7. Then the remainder is 3. You will use another 0. You will use 4, fourth multiple. It will be 20. From here you start to see the same sequence which you had in the beginning. Same sequence ban raha hai. Right? So you know you need not show this. You can just leave it till here. But remember, decimal part jab aapka repeat hona start hoga, ye dashes dikhane zaruri hai. Dashes ka matlab aapki division aage chal rahi hai, but you are not showing it. So answer for the first fraction, 5 by 7 in decimal.
You can also put a bar also.
Yes, that's what I'm going to do here. So this is what I'm going to write down here. So just a bar, this means this block of digits is going to repeat itself. And similarly, you have to convert the other fraction, 9 by 11. So we just continue.
0.714285 is a rational number.
Yes, it's a rational number. So if we just convert the second rational number, 9 by 11, again, you can see that you will be able to see a sequence. Now, at this point, we are back to the start. So if we continued here, you would have used a 0, then another 8, multiple would be 88, remainder is 2, bringing another 0, multiple 1, and then, yes, this keeps going on and on and on. So your second rational number, which was 9 by 11, has been converted into a decimal number, and the decimal form for 9 by 11 is non-terminating because of these dashes. Non-terminating and repeating, which we have represented with a bar. Let me know if the first step is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So once you've converted this, then we have the second step where we want to find out the numbers between them. So step two is actually writing down the numbers between these two values. So now we want to find out irrational numbers between. Hamare paas pehle tha 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. I'm now going to use the decimal values. So 0.714285 bar and 0.81 covered with the bar. Ab mujhe in dono ke beech mein decimal numbers dhoondne hain. And what I'm going to do is, you will be following the trick which you used in question number 7. Yesterday I was discussing jab aapko irrational numbers likhne hain. Or you want to write down decimal numbers whose expansion is non-terminating, non-recurring. Kirat, is anyone in your class whose brother is Kirat? Alright. So when we want to find out irrational numbers, that means we want to find decimal numbers whose expansion is non-ending and non-repeating. हमें इस तरह के decimal numbers चाहिए. Keeping these two things in mind, कि हम उस तरह के decimal numbers ढूंढना चाहते हैं जिनकी expansion non-ending, non-repeating हो. We will be writing down our answer in between these two. इन दोनों values के बीच में जो numbers आ रहे हैं. Now there are infinitely many decimal numbers lying between these two. Let's just watch this. If you have 0.714285 bar and you have 0.81 bar, these two can be written as, now this can be written as 0.714285, 714285, 714285, so on, and this one over here can be written as 0.8181, so on. If you just look at the decimal places, I hope you're aware what decimal places are. Point ke baad jo digits hain. So we have this. So roughly saying, these two lie between 0.7 and 0.9. Or let's take a smaller value. So you want to stay between 0.71 and 0.81. I can write 0.720, 0720, 72000.
I can't understand 0.71, 0.8.
Beta, jab hum decimal values likhte hain, aapke paas, there was a question in 7th standard or maybe 6th standard. Okay, I'll just simply ask you a question. Can you tell me between which two decimal numbers 2.5 lies? अगर आपको नंबर लाइन पे इसको शो करना हो, इट विल बी अपीयरिंग बिटवीन 2 and 3.
यस मैम.
राइट, सो दिस इज समवट लाइक दिस. यहाँ पे जो मेरे पास वैल्यूज है, आई गॉट 0.71 समथिंग एंड आई गॉट 0.81 समथिंग. उसके बाद आगे क्या आ रहा है, आई एम नॉट कंसर्न्ड विद दैट. आई जस्ट सिंपली वॉन्ट टू कंसिडर कि जो मेरे पास ये दो वैल्यूज है ये कहाँ पे आ रही है. 0.7 इसके पहले आएगा. 0.7 means 0.70. 0.70 इसके पहले आएगा और इससे पहले आएगा 0.80. So I want to stay between these two. इन दोनों के बीच में आपको वैल्यू ढूंढनी है. 0.71 up to 0.80. Have you ever seen how heights are measured in meters? Height measure करते हैं, वो बोलते हैं 1.58 meters, 1.59 meters, 1.60 meters or whatever. This way. So, हम बीच में values लिख रहे हैं. Okay, let's just do this from the beginning. The first thing we want to know is you have converted your decimal rational numbers into decimal form. Once you have converted your rational numbers into decimal form, you can identify ki jo aapke rational numbers in decimal form hai wo kaun si range mein lie kar rahe hain. If you had to observe ki inki range kya hai, so irrespective of this big decimal part, हम सिर्फ अगर पहले दो digits consider कर लें, you can, okay, आपको पहले दो भी consider करने की जरूरत नहीं है, आप first decimal place तक consider कर सकते हैं, only up to 10th place. So you have 0.7 something and over here you have 0.8 something. You want to write down values between these. और इनके बीच में जब आपको values लिखनी है, the simplest way to do is convert these into equivalent decimal numbers. So, aap iske piche zero laga sakte ho aur yahan pe bhi aap zero laga sakte ho. So try writing numbers between these two. Instead of zero, I would suggest yahan pe aap isse aage chale jao 0.71 because you want to stay ahead of this number. Aapko isse larger number likhna hai. A decimal number which is larger than this one over here. अगर आपको ये भी कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं पता चल रहा, सिंपली थिंक ऑफ अ डेसिमल नंबर विच वुड बी लार्जर देन दिस वन. इससे बड़ा डेसिमल नंबर आप ढूंढने की कोशिश करो.
0.7250.7255.
या दैट्स राइट. नाउ अ डेसिमल नंबर लार्जर देन दिस वुड बी 0.72, बट वी वॉन्ट टू राइट डाउन इरेशनल नंबर. So what we're going to ensure is that the decimal expansion should be non-terminating and non-repeating. ये अगर मैं ऐसे लिखती हूँ, this number 0.72 इसके बाद आता है, 0.71 वाले number के बाद आता है. लेकिन अभी ये irrational नहीं है, आपको इसको irrational form में बताना है. तो irrational बनाने के लिए just try to write down a sequence of digits which does not make any repeating pattern, and the sequence should have dashes after it. Once again, आपको 0.71 वाले नंबर से लेके 0.81 वाले नंबर्स के बीच में डेसिमल नंबर्स लिखने हैं. पहली बात, तो एक डेसिमल नंबर है 0.72, वो 0.71 वाले नंबर के बाद में आता है. So this works. लेकिन अभी ये irrational नहीं है. This as such right now is not irrational. I want to make it irrational. और इस 0.72 वाली वैल्यू को irrational बनाने के लिए मैं क्या करूंगी, I'm going to make a sequence of digits in the decimal part which does not form a pattern of repeating digits, and second thing, it should be non-ending. If you can understand, are you following what I'm saying right now? If anyone who has a question.
नो मैम.
अब इसके बाद ये भी आ रहा है, 0.73 आता है, 0.74 है, 0.75 है, 0.76 है, ये सारे नंबर्स बीच में आते हैं, लेकिन ये इरेशनल नहीं है. लेट्स मेक देम इरेशनल. टू मेक देम इरेशनल, डिजिट्स का पीछे सीक्वेंस लिखो बट रिपीट नहीं करना. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 लास्ट पार्ट, उस तरह का बना लो यहाँ पे सीक्वेंस. सो यू कैन डू दिस एंड देन put dashes to keep it non-ending. Same thing can be done over here. And it's not necessary that you have to use 0. You can use any other digit. And then over here you can use maybe 5, 7, 4, 5, 5, then 7, 4, 5, 5, then 7, 4, and so on. And same thing can be done to these two also. So as such, we require only 3. Is this clear? Anyone? Anyone who would like to ask a question? All right. So let's just do one additional question here. Just to understand what this is, all right? So note down a question here. I'll be taking the fractions from first exercise. Okay. So let's just take 3 by 4 and 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. How can we do this? This is from exercise 1.1 and this is from exercise 1.3. Now this has a different method to find rational numbers. Iska method alag hai. Irrational ka method alag hai. Rational numbers dhoondne hai to hum fractions ko like fractions banate hain. अगर बीच में नंबर्स मिल गए वेल एंड गुड, अदरवाइज हम इनको मल्टीप्लाई करते हैं विद एनी नंबर ऑफ आवर चॉइस एंड देन वी कैन फाइंड आउट रैशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन द न्यू रैशनल नंबर्स ऑब्टेन्ड. इरेशनल नंबर्स जब फाइंड करने हैं द फर्स्ट स्टेप विल बी टू कन्वर्ट दीज टू इनटू डेसिमल फॉर्म. डेसिमल फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करने के बाद आप फिर इनके बीच में इरेशनल नंबर्स ढूंढ सकते हो. बट अगर क्वेश्चन आ रहा है जहां पे आपको रैशनल और इरेशनल दोनों ढूंढने हैं, आई सजेस्ट यू गो विद द मेथड यूज्ड फॉर irrational numbers. सिर्फ हम second method को use करके ये दोनों answers दे सकते हैं. If you want, you can use two different methods separately. पहले आप rational के लिए काम कर लो, फिर आप irrational के लिए काम कर लो. I suggest that we work with the second method to find irrational numbers. So step one will be to convert our given numbers into decimal form. So 3 by 5 will be 0.6 and 4 by 5 will be equal to 0.8. Is that right? Now, these expansions are terminating. Both the expansions are terminating here. So, I want to write down numbers between these two. The second step is to find numbers between these two. If I had to find out rational numbers.
62 upon 100.
Rational numbers between 0.6 and 0.8. So simply as Karan said, Karan is using a fractional value. I'm going to write in decimal form. I know that rational numbers ki jo decimal expansion hogi, it is either terminating or it is non-terminating repeating. So I can write down 0.61, 0.62. These are terminating like these, or I could write down 0.61, 61, 61, 0.62. 62, so on. And on the other hand, if I had to write down irrational numbers, between 0.6 and 0.8, I will do what I did in the previous question. I'm going to write down decimal numbers whose expansion is non-terminating and non-repeating. So I'll be using 0.61, 6, 1, 1, then 6, 111, so on. Just put a 6 here, and then you could use 0.620, 6200, 6200, 62, so on. Let me know if this is clear, the difference between two questions.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone who would like to ask a question here? Anyone? This is an important question that I exam mein aa jata hai. And be very careful, aapko rational numbers puche gaye hain ya irrational numbers puche gaye hain. Alright. After this, we are proceeding with the questions that are left. Question number third, the second most important question of the exercise. You have to express these decimal numbers in the form P by Q. अब यहाँ पे अगर मैं बात करूँ आपके पास जो values दी हैं, the following are decimals. जो आपको पार्ट्स दिए हैं वो सारे के सारे डेसिमल नंबर्स हैं. आपको इन डेसिमल नंबर्स को P by Q form में लिखना है, जहाँ पे P by Q are integers and Q is not zero. So that means all these decimals are to be converted into rationals. This is your question. And if you look at the decimal numbers given in this particular question, the parts have a decimal expansion, which is non-terminating and repeating. इस क्वेश्चन में जितने भी आपको डेसिमल नंबर्स दिए हैं उन सभी की एक्सपेंशन नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग रिपीटिंग है. नाउ दिस कुड ऑल्सो बी asked for decimal numbers whose expansion is terminating. मैं first part ले रही हूँ. अगर 0.6 होता सिर्फ, this is also a decimal number. Can you convert it into a rational number?
6 by 10.
This can simply be written as 6 by 10. If you want, you can reduce it to the lowest terms. This will be 3 by 5. This will be 3 by 5. लेकिन यहाँ पे जो आपके पास डेसिमल नंबर्स हैं, दे डू नॉट हैव अ टर्मिनेटिंग एक्सपेंशन. इस डेसिमल नंबर की जो एक्सपेंशन थी वो टर्मिनेटिंग थी. यहाँ पे जो पार्ट्स दिए हैं इनकी एक्सपेंशन जो है वो टर्मिनेटिंग नहीं है. द एक्सपेंशंस आर नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग. तो आपके पास अभी जो फर्स्ट पार्ट है इट इज हैविंग बार ऑन 6. सो दिस एक्चुअली मीन्स दैट द नंबर इज ऑफ दिस फॉर्म. द डेसिमल नंबर दैट वी हैव इज ऑफ दिस फॉर्म. इसको कैसे कन्वर्ट करना है इनटू अ फ्रैक्शन? दिस इज द क्वेश्चन दैट इज यूजुअली आस्क्ड इन एग्जाम. आई होप इट्स क्लियर व्हाट द क्वेश्चन इज. दो तरह की कन्वर्जन है. यू कैन कन्वर्ट डेसिमल नंबर्स इनटू रैशनल नंबर्स. दिस वन ओवर हियर इज अ टर्मिनेटिंग. दिस इज अ टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल नंबर. इसको आप कन्वर्ट कर सकते हो इनटू रैशनल फॉर्म वेरी इजीली. द सेकेंड टाइप इज दिस वन वेर योर डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन इज नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग because of these dashes and it's repeating. This can also be converted into form P by Q. Then finally we have this type of decimal expansion which is non-terminating and non-repeating. Now this form cannot be converted into P by Q form. Isko hum P by Q form mein nahi likh sakte. Terminating form can be converted. Terminating, non-terminating, repeating can also be converted to P by Q form. But this one over here, which is non-terminating, non-repeating, cannot be converted into P by Q form. So, जब भी question आएगा to convert a decimal number into P by Q form, तो आपके पास इस तरह के दो parts आएंगे, either terminating or bar, the ones with bar. Now, the one which is terminating, that you know how to do. We are going to do the ones with bar on the top. So let's just consider the first bar that we have 0.6 bar. So the first thing we want to do is we want to represent the given decimal number with a variable. So we are writing this as x equals to 0.6 bar. So this basically means that the value of x is this. And you can mark this as the first equation, or you can just mark x equal to 0.6 bar as 1. I'm going to mark this. And please don't forget to use these dashes at the end. These are important. This is first step where you let your decimal number represented by a variable. Then second step is to write down the multiple of this decimal number. And the multiple of this decimal number will be written keeping in mind how many digits are repeating in the decimal part. Decimal part mein kitne digits repeat ho rahe hain?
One.
Single digit is repeating. So if single digit is repeating, I'm going to multiply my x with 10. Aapko 10th multiple likhna hai uska. So multiplying my equation number 1 into 10. So this will be 10x equals to 0.666 so on multiplied with 10. Left hand side is multiplied with 10. Right hand side is also multiplied with 10. Yahan pe 10 se multiply karke ye ban gaya, and over here this is also to be multiplied with 10. So x multiplied by 10 is 10x simply. And when you multiply with 10, what happens is the point moves to the right by one place. The point move kar jayega aapka, yahan pe aapka ban jayega 6.666 so on. We are actually trying to make a pattern here. What you will see is when you multiply with 10, even after multiplication with 10, point ke baad jo sequence of digits hai, wo same hai as in the given number. Now one of the students is asking me, humne 10 se kyun multiply kiya hai? Purpose ye hai, jab aap 10 se multiply karoge, the sequence after point, multiplication ke baad bhi jo naya answer aapko mila hai, इस नंबर में यहाँ पे पॉइंट के बाद सेम सीक्वेंस रिपीट हो रहा है जो बिगिनिंग में था. यहाँ पे इट्स इज द सेम. अगर टू डिजिट्स रिपीट हो रहे होंगे, वी आर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई विद 100. अगर थ्री डिजिट्स रिपीट हो रहा है, वी आर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई विद 1000. उसका एडवांटेज आपको पता चल जाएगा व्हेन वी परफॉर्म द थर्ड स्टेप. नाउ वी हैव स्टेप नंबर 3. दिस इज द सेकेंड रिजल्ट दैट वी हैव ऑब्टेन्ड. And using the first two results, I'm going to obtain my answer. So what I want to do here is I want to subtract these two results. Result number 1 and result number 2, keeping in mind which is larger. So I'm going to take equation number 2 and subtract equation number 1. So second equation is this. इसमें से मुझे subtract करना है first equation को. Just subtract and obtain the answer. Left hand side subtracted from left hand side. Right hand side subtracted from right hand side. So this is 6. Left hand side. Yes. And right hand side is 6.666 and this one. Inko subtract karna hai aapko. So 10x minus x will be
9x equal to 6.
And over here it will be 6.000 so on. So what happened here was, because of multiplication with 10, point ke baad same sequence tha, sixes ka sequence tha. Beginning mein bhi jo sequence tha, wo sixes ka tha, so decimal part completely eliminate ho gaya aapka. Point ke baad there is nothing left. And now x is equal to 6/9, which is of the form p by q. And you can reduce it to the simplest terms.
2/3.
So x is equal to 2/3. And if you convert, agar aap 2/3 ko decimal form mein convert karte ho, by carrying out division, you will see that the answer is actually this, 0.66666. So on. Anyone who would like to ask a question here? Anyone with any query?
No.
All right. So we will just leave it here. If you want, we have just a minute left. Okay, we have 2 minutes left. Are you free after this class, I suppose?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll just take then the next minute to discuss the second part. Let's do the second part of this question. We have 0.47 bar. The bar is only on 7.
Multiply by 10 first.
So the first step is to represent this as x. So let x equals to 0.47 bar. This actually means that x is equal to 0.47 is the repeating part. 7 is the part which is repeating itself. This is step number 1. Step number 2 is depending on the number of digits which are repeating. So single digit is repeating.
Multiply by 10 on both sides.
Multiply by 10 on both sides. So this will be 10x. You can write down. Multiply with 10 on both sides. This is one way of writing it, or you can simply write down that equation number 1 has been multiplied with 10. So equation number 1 multiplied with 10 will give you your second step. This means this value is multiplied with 10. So this gives you 10x equals to, now the point will move 1.7 bar. So this will be
4.7 bar.
So on. This is the second result. And then finally, we have the third step where we subtract equation number 2 and equation number 1. So left-hand side subtracted,